Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to program a Honeywell 5834-4 wireless 4-button key fob to our Honeywell Lyric security system. So the 5834-4 was the most popular 5800 series wireless key fob, and if you ever had an existing Honeywell wireless system and you've upgraded to the Lyric, you may already have one of these key fobs. And the good one of the best features of the Lyric is that it supports backwards compatibility to any 5800 series device, which means you don't have to replace this with a brand new Lyric key fob if you don't want to. You can use your existing 5834-4 and simply program it and have it work. So it's really nice that the Lyric offers the flexibility to use the new encrypted bi-directional 6 series devices, but you can still use the old style 5800 series devices as well. And we're going to just show you how to enroll this fob to the panel. And the first thing you want to determine on your key fob is what color lights up when you press a button. So in this case, you see it's lighting up green. I don't know if you can see that in the video, but the LED is green. Okay. And that would be the standard security mode, not encrypted or high security mode. We can toggle that mode, the local mode of the fob, by pressing a sequence of buttons. The top left button and the bottom two buttons together for 5 seconds. And now when we hold the button down, it's lighting up red, okay? So red means the fob is in high security mode. If you press the top right button and the bottom two buttons for 5 seconds, then it'll toggle it out of high security mode back into standard security mode. And again, when we light it up, we're getting the green light. So the first thing you need to know is what mode is your fob in? If you're an older fob that was enrolled, let's say prior to 2015, then you're probably in standard security and you're probably lighting up green. If it's a new key fob purchased in 2015 or later, then you're probably in the high security mode. Honeywell, in anticipation of the Lyric system coming out, and because the Lyric is encrypted to its sensors, they know that this whole idea of wireless encryption is gonna be a kind of a hot button topic in the industry. And therefore they wanna make everything as secure as possible. So they've begun to ship this unit in the high security mode. So if you just got one of these devices and you press your button and it's lighting up red, then you know your fob is already in high security mode. So that's the first thing to determine is, are we in high security or not? If we are, or we're not, either way, we have to program the fob to the system. And to do that, we do security followed by tools. We type 4112, which is our default installer code. If you're seeing this screen, it means you're not yet associated with a monitoring provider, which is fine. This system works a lot better with Total Connect service or monitoring service, but it also can be used as a local system. And if we just ignore the AlarmNet 360 stuff and say no, then we can hit program and we're in the zone programming option now, or the panel configuration options. When we're doing zones, that's for all the sensors. When we're doing key fobs, we use the keys button. You can see no items to display. We have yet to enroll a key fob to the Lyric panel, so we hit add new. We can see we're in a key fob. It's going to start with zone 131. There's 130 zones of protection for the Lyric. First two are hardwired zones. Up to 126 is wireless. From 3 to 126 is wireless. From 127 to 130 are the garage door zones. And then from 131 up to 162 is the key fob zones. And on a key fob, every program button is a zone. This device can actually be programmed for 2-button activations as well. So you could have an 8 zone key fob as well. For our case, we're just going to use the arm away function, top left, disarm, top right, arm stay, top left, and we're going to set this bottom right button up as an audible panic. So our end user has a way to set off a panic alarm from their key fob. So now that we know how the fob works and we know how to determine if it's high security or low security, we can go ahead and program it. So first thing we do is serial number. We tap into that box and we have our keypad screen here. We can type the serial number from the back of the fob, but just like we've shown you in our other sensor programming videos, it's much better to auto enroll the device because it A, makes sure we don't make a mistake on the serial number input, and B, it makes sure that the sensor's working because it actually confirms that the system sees the device. So before we've actually programmed anything, we just press and hold the button. You hear that beep, you let go. You wait a couple seconds, you press and hold the same button, you hear a double beep. And now you see the serial number, which is exactly the same serial number on the sticker. And you see loop number 3, which is the loop number for this particular zone or this button. Press and hold one more time. And we now have it set with a serial number on the zone. And we can see button key number 1 is the arm away or the lock. Button key number 2 is the disarm or the unlock. And button key 3 is the arm stay or the picture of the guy in the house. And then finally, button 4, it was set no alarm response by default. Or no response, meaning this button wouldn't do anything by default. However, we want it to be a 24-hour audible alarm. So 24 hours, that means the system's armed or disarmed. If this button's pressed and held, you're gonna get an audible siren tone from the panel. All of the function buttons on this fob are a press and hold, just to point that out. So when you're doing your testing, don't just press and release because it is a press and a hold, like a 2-second, 3-second hold. Before we save our parameters, the last thing we need to do is associate this key fob with a user. So if we tap into the users, we can see all of the available user slots that this panel supports, which it supports up to 46, although technically there's a guest and a duress code user as well. You just can't pair a fob to one of those two. So if we go and the guest and the duress were at the top, so you can program a fob to a guest or duress code. But for our purposes, we haven't set any of these sub-users. So the only user we have in the panel right now is the master. And by assigning it to a user and saving it, we now see we have a fob, zones 131 through 134, 31, 32, 33, 34. Those are the four buttons, the four zones. And if we come to the home screen, acknowledge our comm trouble error, we've programmed our fob. If we try to activate the fob, nothing happens. Okay? That doesn't mean we made a mistake. That's by design. With this red light lit up, we're in high security mode at the fob, but we haven't learned this fob into the panel through the high security learn mode to tell the system in the panel and the, I'm sorry, to tell the panel and the fob that they're both in high security mode to work. So one thing you could do is set it back to standard security mode. So if you press all the buttons except for the arm away button, now we're back lighting up green when we press a button. If we press the arm away button, it arms. Press and hold the disarm button, it disarms. Press and hold stay. Arms to stay. Same idea as disarming with the disarm button. And finally, we can test the panic. That's our audible panic alarm. We can disarm. We can disarm again to clear the cancel. And we have a working fob, all right? But there's a reason Honeywell ships it into high security mode. So let's go ahead and put it back into that mode. Just like with a garage door remote controller, it is possible that someone can, with the right technology and in range of when you're using your garage door, it can see the rolling digits that are sent or the string of digits that are sent when your garage door controller activates your garage door. This fob works very similar technology. It sends a string of digits to the panel when there's an alarm event, or rather when there's an activation, arming, disarming, arming, stay. So if someone was listening in on your RF transmissions from your fob and you were in the standard security mode, they could then get a sequence or a simulation of your fob and they would be able to disarm your system without having your code. And that's a big security risk. So once we put it back into high security mode and it's lighting up red, it's no longer working to the panel again. Arming and disarming is not doing anything. So again, if you've programmed everything the way we showed you and you're not getting your fob to work, it's because you have to do one more step. If you do tools, 4112, ignore the whole AlarmNet 360 prompt if you have it. We'll give it a minute to connect and we'll say no. We are able to then go to test. And it's very important you choose go, no go test. It will seem like not much has happened, but you did hear the beep. And you can also see go, no go test, home to quit. This is a test mode that you can use to verify that your sensors are working. So if you go and open a door, it'll show that that door faulted. In our case, it's the way to put it into high security mode. So when you're in go, no go, if you press and hold every button except for the panic button, so top two and bottom left, till it beeps twice, you heard the beep and the double beep. Now we've put it into high security mode. To confirm that we did that, the way to exit go, no, go mode is to disarm the system. So if we try to go back to the home screen and disarm, then we could test the fob and make sure it's working. But I always like to show you the shortcuts. If you press and hold the home, the disarm button, because we know that we've already learned in the high security mode, we can press and hold this, it'll disarm, which will verify that the fob is working. Disarm, ready to arm. We press the button. It lit up red. We know we're in high security mode. And we have a working fob again. Armed away. Disarmed. So hitting that disarm button when you're in the go, no, go test mode, after you've already done the pressing and holding of every button except for the panic, you're in the mode for high security and you can now disarm to clear the go, no, go test. And you know it's working. So it kills two birds with one stone there. All right, so that is how to program a 5834-4 wireless four button key fob to your Honeywell Lyric. And using the high security mode, you know you're basically encrypted to the system. So a 5834-4 in high security mode is very high security to this Lyric system, even though you're not using one of the truly encrypted Lyric key fobs. So it's a good way to use an existing 5834-4 with the Lyric. Hopefully you've enjoyed that video on how to enroll it and how to use the high security and the standard security. If you have any questions on programming your 5834-4 to your Honeywell Lyric, please email support@alarmgrid.com and make sure to subscribe to our channel as we'll be releasing many more videos about this great new all-in-one wireless Honeywell Lyric security system.